Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use weighted deformers in four ways. The weighted deform node can be used for both simple and advanced deformations, and is best used when you have textures or designs that have been drawn inside a shape, such as textile designs for clothing pieces or a simple face design. So let's start. On its own, the envelope deformation is designed to deform the contours of a drawing without affecting the width of its outline. This works very well with flat color drawings, but not so well with bitmap textures or detail-heavy drawings. Take a look at how a drawing of a face with an envelope deformer reacts when it is stretched. Oh dear, you can see that pretty quickly the face details tear or break, which doesn't look so good and off-model. Let's look at how the same faced emoji drawing reacts with a weighted deform node added. The face detail stays on model and deforms evenly with the head shape. Looks great. I'll show you how this works. You'll need to design your own face emoji. Have fun, maybe express how you're feeling. Make two drawings, one drawing of the head shape and another drawing for the face expression. You have two drawings, attach a cutter to the face. Take a connector from under the head drawing and attach it to the cutter's matte port. Invert cut by double tapping. We'll assume you've watched our invert cutting tutorial. I'll pin a link to the comments below. Add pegs to the two drawings. Hold Shift and Command and hit P. Add your pivot points. Select the head drawing. Animation. Envelope Creator. Create envelope. Or add the envelope deformer manually. Take a look at our deforms tutorial, and for this I'll pin a link to the comments below. Get the node library up by hitting enter. Find the weighted deform node by typing in the first two letters. The weighted deform node is attached by dragging a cable from the output port of the deformation chain to the left side of the weighted deform node. Just like magic, you'll see a new input port will be created. It's a different color to the rightmost input of the weighted deform node. Connect the main peg to the right port. Take another cable from the weighted deform node output port and connect that to the peg of the face. The connection going from the deformation chain to the drawing node will automatically be removed when you create a connection going from the weighted deform node to the drawing node. Let's test it. Select the envelope deformer and show selected deformers. Have fun squashing and stretching your face emoji. Try adding drawing substitutions to create emotion changes. You can also combine deformation chains and free deformation points. The weighted deform node can act as a composite for several deformation methods. For example, if you create an envelope inside a drawing, then add free deformation points outside of the envelope, the free deformation points will deform the drawing outside of the envelope only. This could be useful for hair, a moustache, or loose appendages. For this exercise, you can use the same face emoji and add two more drawings, one for hair shape and another for hair texture. Invert cut the hair texture with the hair shape. Add a parent peg. Get a weighted deform node from the node library and connect all the drawings. Add a weighted deformer to the first drawing and attach it to all the other drawings. Add an envelope deformer. To do this, select the weighted deformer, then create the deformation chain. This will come in without a group, which can look messy, but you can select the offset and curves to group them. Shortcut Command G. Create a peg node for each free deformation point you want to add. Shortcut Command P. Number the pegs. Add the pivot points for each peg. Connect the output port of each peg node to the input of the weighted deform node. New input ports will appear on the weighted deform node as you drag connection cables from other nodes towards it. Connect the output port of the parent peg of the weighted deformation system to the input port of the peg nodes you just created. In the Advanced Animation Toolbar, you can select the Translate tool to move the piece. Select one of the pegs and test it. You can also move the pieces using the crosshair. Here's a character design where I've used textures on the coats of the dog walker and her dog. Over here in the node view, you can see in this example, I've invert cut the textile design with the coat and created an envelope deformer. I've applied the weighted deform node system to my rig for the dog walker as seen on the face emoji. Finally, here's my last example for another application using weighted deformers. I've discovered how easy and effective it is for deforming text. In this example, I've placed the text inside a rectangle shape and created an envelope deformer. The weighted deform node is added to the shape and the text. I then take down the alpha to 0 to make it completely transparent, and voila, the text is warped beautifully. And that's how you can add weighted deformers in 4 ways, including the hair. Rigging hair is an excellent way to bring style and vibrancy to your creations. So why not check out my full tutorial on rigging hair, where we cover the fundamentals from the ground up. Thanks for watching. See you next time.